Imagine, if you will, that future humans manage to travel to other worlds and find, well, more humans. If some scientists are to be believed, then the blue and green alien humanoids you see on Star Trek could be, well, actually out there. An evolutionary paleobiologist named Simon Conway Morris believes that researchers can say with reasonable confidence that human-like evolution has occurred in other locations around the universe. The core of this belief comes from a certain theory of evolution, which claims that random effects eventually average out so that evolution comes together to produce similar organisms in any given environment. The research used the examples of flight mechanism, which has evolved independently on Earth at least 4 times so far in birds, bats, insects and pterosaurs. All of these creatures have wings, a common feature amongst them that sets them apart from flightless species. All this is well and good, but it brings us back to square one when we wonder where everybody is, just as Enrico Fermi did decades ago. It was the summer of 1950. The setting was the Los Alamos National Laboratory, New Mexico. While having lunch, Enrico Fermi and a couple of his friends were having in-depth conversations about recent UFO sightings reports, alien vandalism in New York City, and the possibility of light travel. Just your regular schmegular lunchtime chit-chat. When, suddenly, Fermi blurted out, "Don't you wonder where everybody is?" His question was not intended to ask why all of his friends had not come for lunch that day. Instead, he meant to ask why Earth showed no signs of extraterrestrial life. Although Fermi's outburst was seemingly harmless, it left in its wake an extraordinary paradox that continues to baffle scientists, even today, several decades after his demise. The conundrum got drowned in a babble of skeptical, mildly uncomfortable laughter. However, the incongruity between the lack of evidence of extraterrestrial life and the high probability of its existence has to date not been explained. Over the years, several more hypotheses have arisen that have brought into focus the apparent contradiction, now widely known as the Fermi paradox. If life happened here, then it likely happened elsewhere. But as far as we can tell, we are totally alone. So where is everybody?
Orbit. Beyond the blue.
Over the decades, astronomers, astrobiologists, and scientists have proposed many solutions to this paradox. One idea, called the rare Earth hypothesis, even suggests that perhaps life really is that special and that unique on the cosmic scale. In this scenario, emergence of life is so incredibly rare that we may be among the first creatures or any kind to arise in the Milky Way. In other words, the circumstances that led to the emergence of life on Earth are so special that even with trillions of other worlds, life happened essentially only once. Another proposed solution, known as the Great Filter Hypothesis, postulates that perhaps life is common, but intelligent life is what's difficult. After all, life appeared relatively early in the history of our planet, but it took billions of years for intelligence to arise. Which could mean that perhaps we are incredibly lucky to have the brains we do. And even with all this cognitive development and critical thinking abilities, the introduction of nuclear weapons and climate change have put the future of our species in doubt. So, while we may find bacteria or other simple organisms throughout the galaxy, it's unlikely that we will meet anybody capable of conversation. One even suggests that we're simply not interesting enough yet. Ouch. What it means is that perhaps we're just being impatient as of now. Maybe, with a multitude of worlds to potentially study, alien civilizations would likely wait for one to start broadcasting their presence before sending a probe. So, if we wait a few hundred or a few thousand years, somebody might come knocking. But one new solution really stands out. Yes, wake up guys, a new Fermi solution just dropped. This theory suggests that killer moons are taking out extraterrestrials. We promise it's not as ridiculous as it sounds. Let's start by taking the example we know best. Our moon, Luna, our beautiful natural satellite. Did you know that with every passing year, the moon is slowly escaping Earth's orbit, quite literally inching away at a rate of roughly 1.5 inches per year? Eventually, the moon will be completely unbound from our planet, in some unimaginably distant future billions of years from now when the sun has already exploded. Naturally, we presume, it is the same process that will be shared by exomoons of exoplanets. According to a new study published in the journal Monthly Notices of the Royal Astronomical Sciences, exomoons that revolve around an exoplanet outside our solar system could be crashing into their host planets and wiping out any chances for life, for even existing life, on a shockingly regular basis. Life on a distant exoplanet could be getting wiped off this very minute as you are watching this. By using simulations, a study found that depending on how close the exoplanet is to the system's star, the timeline of such a collision could be drastically accelerated, making it possible for an untethered moon to come crashing back into its former host a mere billion years into the planet's formation. Either way, with a fast timeline or a slow one, the research concluded that an unbound moon eventually will collide with its parent planet. That is the overwhelmingly most likely long-term possibility. That's not good news for potential alien worlds, or even ours, for that matter. Since time immemorial, moons have been an essential factor in fostering a livable climate in the first place. Moons are often considered helpful because they help stabilize a planet's axis, allowing for stable climates and seasons that are better suited for harboring life. So, any planet that life crops up on in the universe will have a built-in, ticking time bomb that may sterilize an inhabited or habitable planet. Could this be the reason why we haven't met any other civilization yet? At the end of the day, these are all hypotheses. But we are entering an era when we are going to have actual data relevant to life on other planets. New probes, larger, stronger, and faster space telescopes, and upcoming missions couldn't be more relevant than in the moment we live. Maybe we are not alone, and have never been. Or maybe we Earthlings are truly that special after all, but what do I know?
Orbit. Beyond the blue.